Hi, I'm Tina. I was diagnosed with breast cancer last October. The first sentence I was told was that I had it, and the second was that there was no concerns over me, and that's basically what I focused on all the way through. And I think I've got through it all pretty swiftly and easily. And I don't think I was very sick at all. I was very lucky. But there's, my mum died of breast cancer when she was 54, so since I'm 30, I'm getting yearly mammograms, and basically it was the mammogram that picked it up. Did I notice anything? Maybe one breast was denser than the other is all I might have noticed, and that's what picked it up. Next was called back for an ultrasound, which had happened before, so I wasn't thinking or worrying about that. And while I was there for the ultrasound, they did a biopsy, so then I kind of knew myself because that had never happened before. So when I was called back for results, I wasn't shocked at all. I was expecting it. And I suppose with history and my mum and her sister, my dad's two sisters, all had breast cancer, so I was kind of expecting it. So in a way, it was a little bit of a relief that it had finally, eventually reared its head and it was being dealt with. And Professor Kieran said, very easily dealt with. Next was, I suppose, for me, I thought that was maybe a Thursday, and I thought Monday it was all going to start. So no, it was about 5 weeks to wait, which I didn't know it was going to be 5 weeks. So that was like, oh, is it getting bigger, and is it going to get worse? So I rang one of the nurses, and she said, no, don't be worried. So they called me in, and they explained it would be chemo and surgery and radiotherapy. So 7 months ago, I was here and met by a nurse who brought me into the chemo ward, showed me around, introduced me to some nurses there, met Professor Kern and Mac and Keane, and they explained what would happen and dates and times and that. And yeah, so that's when chemo started here. The nurses up there are absolutely fabulous. They're so friendly, they're never in bad humour, they're always up for a laugh and a banter. And one thing I'll say is, like, I'll really miss them when it's all over. Couldn't fault them ever at all. And so I was shown around the first day, and then when it started, they sat down, one of them sat down and explained everything to me about, you know, temperature and feeling sick and mouth ulcers and what to do and who to ring and all that. And then it started off. I suppose there were long days, but just so relaxing there. You have a lovely comfy chair and your book and magazines, and they come with nice little bits to eat. And I just have to say I really enjoyed it. And I had said at the start that I wouldn't refuse any invitation to go anywhere. So actually I'm exhausted after, because everyone keeps inviting you everywhere. So yeah, I'm lucky I got through it so easily. I know lots of people don't, but I did. So the chemo then was once every 2 weeks for 8 rounds, so that lasted maybe 4 months. If I had to be specific, I'd say after the first two were perfect, the second two maybe a dodgy, I wouldn't say dodgy tummy as in that you felt you were going to get sick, but you knew there was something gurgling around in your stomach. And for the last four, maybe there might be 2 days where you would be tired, but not that you couldn't get out of bed tired or couldn't go somewhere tired. I suppose hair loss is another, but I would be thinking there's bonuses with everything. Showers take so much shorter. Getting ready, 4 minutes I timed to myself one time to be ready, because you don't have to dry your hair or straighten your hair or do anything with your hair. So I found that quite handy actually. And then there's no waxing, no shaving. That was very handy too. So I have to say losing hair was a bit of a bonus thing. I didn't do anything with the week. I bought it all right. So because my breast cancer was HER2 positive, the next step after the main chemo was done was this Herceptin treatment every 3 weeks. So it takes half an hour, it's in a drip form. There's, as far as I can see, no ill effects, no effects at all. You go in, you get it done, it's done and dusted. There's no hair loss with it or sickness with it or anything like that. So that's for the next year. So I'll be back to work and I'll just come up every 3 weeks for that. 3 weeks after I finished the chemo, I started the radiotherapy. Dr. Martin had met me twice, I think, beforehand, explained what was going to happen. He meet the radiotherapy team and they explained what was going to be happening. They showed me around and then I came up for that. I think I had 28 sessions every day. They kind of gave you a choice of times for what suited. And again, I drove myself up and down to that and I didn't have any problems with it. I wasn't tired. No problems with it. It was fine. I'm on tamoxifen for 5 years. So the next step is, well, after surgery, the Herceptin until next March and the tamoxifen for another 5 years. And that's it, I hope. It's a hugely different journey than I expected. I suppose for me, I was thinking back to my mum who came home from chemo and was sick and was in bed and tired and not able to eat or sleep badly and didn't particularly much leave the house. So for me, I very early on decided it would be totally different for me, and it, without even trying, was. There's anti-sickness medication now. I was never sick. I didn't suffer from that tiredness that they talk about, so I know I was lucky. And for me, like I'd say, half the time of chemo, those nights out of range that I had to go on, couldn't miss. And I thought I'd be going home at 10 o'clock because I'd be so tired. And no, last girl standing there. So I was lucky. I know it's not everyone's story, but I was lucky. So for telling my family, I didn't tell them for 6-7 weeks maybe. I wanted the story for me to be, again, different from my man. So I decided that I would wait until I'd one chemo done and then that they could see that I was alive and well after it. So I did one chemo and I went over to my dad's and then I went to my sister and my brothers and told them that I had it, number one, and that I was just after my first session of chemo, number two. So I think that hugely eased their minds because I was walking and talking and driving and, no, I would say I had like jelly legs and a jelly tummy, but there was no need to tell any of them that. And yeah, I hope that I made it easier for them. I know they were worried, but they would call to me and I mightn't be there. And they'd ring, where are you? I'm uptown, I'm gone out, I'm this and that. So I think maybe after a week they saw that things weren't changed for me at all. And they definitely relaxed more and I don't even think they would ever consider me sick now at all.